Today, I just want to share a short little story. I think it's very encouraging. It was encouraging to me. Just recently, I met another young person, woman, who works here at the hotel. Her name is Kendall. And, well, I ask people when I ask them what their name is, how did they get their name? Because, that's how you can really strike up usually a good conversation with a stranger because, again, everybody likes to talk about their name, and there is power in your name. So I asked her, how did she get named Kendall? And she said, well, my parents couldn't really think of a name for a couple of days, and they were watching a football game, and all of a sudden one of the players' names was Kendall. And so they picked Kendall. And she said, well, they spelled it a little different than what he spelled his, to make it look more female, I guess. And anyway, it's a kind of neat story. Well, thinking of that, when you think of a person's name, I always try to relate it to the Bible. Now, if they have a Bible name, then it's pretty easy to do. And then you can talk about the Bible. But why would you talk about the Bible? Because ultimately, you want to talk about the Lord. Ultimately, you want to talk about the kingdom of God. And ultimately, you want to ask them if they are born again. Because, Jesus said, unless one is born again, you will in no way enter the kingdom of God. So it doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter what you may think. Jesus himself said, who I believe is the master of the universe, you could say, that if he says that you have to be born again, then you must be born again. So what does that mean to be born again? Well, you have to be born of the Spirit. Obviously, when you're born into the natural life, you're born through water. You're born through a water birth of your mother, a natural birth. But then after that, the only way you're going to see the kingdom of God if you're born of the Spirit. And only way to be born of the Spirit is to believe the gospel, which is the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And it says, if you believe that, you will be saved. Sadly, it's so simple and it's so wonderful what God has done for us, and yet so many will refuse to believe it. They would rather be adamantly against that than believe. And of course, once you do become born again, then God, of course, expects and will help you to grow in the likeness of Jesus. He doesn't want to leave you in this born again state. He wants you to grow and mature in the Lord. So, thinking of that, I think Kendall. So I said, well, that's interesting. I'm going to see what I can think about that. Well, I couldn't think of anything right at the moment, so I prayed about it a little, and I came up with her name in the Bible. Now, it's funny because her name, as far as a person, as a proper name, as far as I know, Kendall is not in the Bible. But I want to read this verse that finally came to my mind through the power of the Holy Spirit, which is found in 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 6. And it says this, "For this reason, I remind you to kindle afresh the gift of God which is in you through the laying on of my hands." Now, this version where it says the kindle, the flame, is found in the New American Standard Version, because obviously it depends on sometimes the translation of the Bible you read, what word they might use for that word kindle. In other version, it says to fan into flames. So basically, if you could think of it like this, obviously Paul is talking to a born again person here, and he's wanting them to understand that, they're born again, obviously, but as a born again believer, your fire can begin, your fire, your zeal, your passion for the Lord can diminish. It can wane and almost dry up. There's a place in Revelations where it says that the people had lost their first love, and of course their first love is the love of Jesus. And so many times in this life, we get so busy with every other thing that we forget the most important thing of our whole life, which is our relationship with the Lord. And it goes on to say, "For God has not given us a spirit of timidity, but of power and love and discipline." And in other versions, that word timidity is fear. And it's so fitting for this message right now, when I look around everywhere and I see people who are really being controlled by a spirit of fear. The whole world seems like they're under this spirit of fear. And what a spirit of fear? Well, it's demonic spirit. It's this, you know, there's the devil, there's Satan, but then he has a whole minion of many demons that are on his side, which of course they will be defeated. But right now they still are doing their terrible work on the earth, which is affecting people. And so you see it. You can physically see people walking around in this spirit of fear. And I don't want to go into the detail, but if you think about it, you can probably understand what I'm talking about. So to go on, this young Kendall, who works here at the hotel, you know, she said, I asked her, was she born again? And I've determined, which is very, I'm so happy because, you know, I love to tell people about the Lord. I love to tell people about Jesus. And so sometimes you start in many different ways. You might say, do you know Jesus? And, you know, it's almost everybody says they know Jesus. You know, it doesn't matter what they're doing and even involved in at the time. But, yeah, oh, yeah, I love the Jesus. I pray to him all the time. And yet they're surely not living for him just from what they're telling you about their life. Or sometimes I might say, well, are you a believer? And this is a person, you know, that they're probably not going to have a lot of contact with. You're only going to maybe be with them for a short moment, maybe at a checkout counter. So you don't really have time to just stand there and take up their time because they're working or whatever. But you have still can get a seed in a faster way if you use that term, are you born again? And I'll tell you, it's really fun because it's like kicking them in the stomach because it totally, you know, gets them off their guard. And they look at you and for a moment, even people who are saved, and they look at you like, and you know, they don't know what to say. And finally, this, oh, yes, I am. I said, so you're a born-again Christian. You've been born in this, you know, and they keep on, yes, yes. Or else if they say no, then you can tell them, would you like me to tell you how you can be born again and explain it? It's just a wonderful thing. But anyway, this young woman, Kendall, who actually where I got this idea, the Lord gave me the idea and the importance of this, you know, she says she was born again, but I don't know where her relationship, how far it is or whatever, because I don't know her really, but I just know her by her name and the fact that she tells me she's born again. But what it made me think is this, you know, when you ask someone this kind of a question, when you say this verse to a person that, you know, you have this flame, if you are a believer in Jesus, you know, a born again believer in Jesus, and you're saved and you know it, you're on your way to heaven, but yet maybe your passion for the Lord is diminished. Maybe you're seeing even your own self be affected by this this spirit of fear. Well, I'm here to tell you this verse is very strong because it says, kindle that fire again. And what does that mean? It means give it some air. Get that fire that's in you, give it some air. Breathe holy life into it and ask the Lord, ask the Holy Spirit to renew the relationship that you have with Jesus and just give it life and get in His Word and get in His, you know, in times alone with Him and pray to Him and let that fire go, that little flame that maybe is there, just go into this roaring bonfire inside of you. And that when people see you, they'll see this spirit, they'll see this fire that's been fanned into flames by the power of the Holy Spirit, by your willing to submit to Him. So I pray that this message helps you. I pray that, you know, if you're in some sort of dilemma or if you're having some sort of troubles, I just pray that by the powerful name of Jesus that you will be relieved of those things and the flame will begin to increase in your heart and in your life. And so I just pray for wonderful things ahead for you as you serve the Lord, as we serve the Lord together. Amen. And God bless you until next time.